Hola, hola chicos. Hoy es miércoles, el 13 de mayo. Sí, feliz miércoles, ya casi es viernes. Hoy vamos a hablar de la comida y los mandatos. Sí, la comida y los mandatos. So, by the end of this lesson, you're going to be able to do a couple different things. The first thing being recognizing simple commands in Spanish, which I know you already know how to do. Understand simple cooking instructions by knowing those commands. Identifying some ingredients in traditional guacamole. And then you're going to be able to make guacamole by the end of this. And unfortunately, you're probably going to be hungry by the end of this as well. Seguimos los mandatos. So, piensan en unos ejemplos. ¿Sí? Piensan en unos ejemplos. Who can give me a couple of examples of some mandatos or some commands? If you can only think of some in English right now, that's okay. But if you know some in Spanish, we can share those as well. So, some of the mandatos that you might have heard in class, or actually in English, let's do those first. So maybe stand up would be a mandato. Call me. Sería un mandato. ¿Qué más? Clean your room. Eso es mandato. And I know all of you have heard that one. Yeah, so in Spanish, what are some ones that you hear in your classroom? Take a second to think about some mandatos that you've heard from your teachers before in Spanish. So some of those might be habla en español. And I apologize, I'm on my computer that does not have the ñ key, so that should be español. Let's see, escucha is another one. O escúchame. Lee. Okay. Lee en voz alta, read out loud. O siéntate. Y, oh, another good example I know I say to my students all the time is repite. Yeah, repite. So what do all of these words have in common? What is a mandato? If you had to tell someone what a command or mandato is, you would be able to tell them that it's something that we use to give instructions or to ask people to do things. So it's when we are talking to someone and we are asking them to do something or telling them to do something. There is an informal and a formal version of those commands. Today, we're just going to talk about the informal version, and we're just going to do the regulars. Mandatos are super easy, but there are a few irregulars, but we're just going to stick with the regular ones today. So, conjugar los verbos es súper fácil. Si tú sabes conjugar los verbos en el presente, es lo mismo. Es súper fácil, ¿sí? Dice, use the third person, it uses the third person singular, so él o ella, of the present tense to form affirmative commands, ¿sí? Por ejemplo, el verbo comprar. Comprar significa to buy. Third person singular sería él compra. O ella compra. So you use that same third person conjugation and that ends up being your mandato. So as long as you are really secure in your conjugations, this is going to be super easy for you. You just have to remember the irregulars. So the words that we're going to practice with are escuchar, leer, y compartir. So the first verb, and this is just a review in case you've kind of forgotten the steps of conjugation. The first verb that we're going to do is escuchar. So we take, and I apologize for my frozen video in the corner. Escuchar, the first step is to take off aire. So it no longer means to listen, and we're just left with escuchar. So third person singular, what is my ending for that? What is my AR ending in the present for third person singular? So my final is going to be escucha. Entonces, escucha significa listen. Escúchame, listen to me. Okay, el segundo, leer. Oh, I'm sorry, that's the wrong screen. Leer. Same thing, I take off my ER ending. So I had leer, which means to read, but now I want to change it to third person singular. So think about ER verbs, present tense, él or ella. What is my new ending going to be? E. Entonces tengo lee. ¿Sí? Lee. Lee libro. Read. Go read your book. En español, claro. The next one, compartir. Compartir significa to share. Compartir, IR verb, take off the IR. Tengo compart. I had to add my ending for IR verbs, present tense, él o ella, third person singular. And that one's easy because it's the same as ER. Hey, entonces tengo comparte. Y eso quería decir como share. Comparte con tu hermano. Comparte las galletas conmigo. Estamos hablando de la comida, entonces tengo mandatos, hacer como mandatos que tienen algo que ver con la comida. ¿Okay? Por ejemplo, come, ¿sí? Come. ¿Cómo voy a saber qué es mandato? How do I know that that is a mandato? Come. Es la E, ¿sí? Come. Eat. El gato dice, come. Come la comida. Ok, aquí. Compra la leche y no te olvides de las galletas. Which one of those verbs is the mandato? Compra. Compra leche. Buy milk. Y no te olvides las galletas. ¿Qué son galletas? Cookies. Y aquí, ¿cuál es el verbo? ¿Cuál es el mandato? Come. Sí, come más pollo. ¿Qué es pollo? Pollo es chicken. Las vacas dicen que quieren que ustedes comen más pollo. ¿Sí? Aquí, los verbos que vamos a usar en la cocina son verbos importantes. ¿Sí? Entonces, if you like to copy down your notes, this would be a great time to copy down these words. If you take notes electronically, this would be a great time to type them out. If you're watching a recorded lesson, you can take this time to pause the video and try to do the ones that you know without my help, and then double check. So let's go through these. Comer. ¿Quién sabe qué significa comer? To eat. Preparar. To prepare. Cortar. Cortar. To cut. Picar. Picar. También es como to cut, pero es como to dice o chop. Añadir. This might be a new one for some people. Añadir. Más. Poner más. To add. Este, no vamos a usar ese. Mezclar. Mezclar. To mix. Y poner. ¿Sí? Poner. To put. So those are going to be some of the words that you are going to be reviewing. You already know the food vocabulary, so now we're going to put those two together and start using your food vocabulary with these mandatos that you're going to hear in the kitchen. Let's go to this infografía. Okay? Identifica los mandatos. I'm going to give you a minute to go through and try to identify all of the mandatos that you see. If you have the capability of writing on your screen, you can do that. And if not, you can just type them down in your notes or wherever you feel comfortable doing that. And then if you are watching a recorded lesson, go ahead and pause and do that, and then you can check your answers. So here are a few that we have. Prepara. Achaca. Corta. Añade. ¿Qué más? Añade. Exprime. Pela. Corta. Y ya, creo que son todos los verbos. Y este verbo, aquí. I had it on my slide before, but there was a typo, and I was wondering why the word pelear was on my screen. There's the correct mandato. So now that we've gone through the introduction lesson for the mandatos, you are going to watch my video on how, cómo hacer guacamole, ¿sí? Vas a identificar los verbos, ¿sí? Los verbos. So I want you to write down two number as you watch my video, and I just want you to write the mandatos in order that you hear them. And you can watch the video as many times as you need, and then I hope that you follow my mandatos y que haces guacamole en casa para tu familia. Gracias. Si tienes preguntas, mándame un correo. O si necesitas ayuda, tienes el link de Quizlet con el vocabulario y también otro video con apuntes. Gracias, chicos. Adiós.